Come hither, me boys, while I make some old noise, and I'll tell you a story, 'twould provoke you to ponder. The state of your life, should you e'er take a wife, would cause nought but strife, and put all joys asunder. The boys of the nation, with great reputation, do swear that they never consent to be true. But when out cavorting, imbibing, and courting, their senses all dulled, they renege on their oath. For the face of a blackguard may look worn and haggard, what fool is his soul, as he tears on the spree? He has no distractions against satisfaction, it's happiest to live single and free. At each wedding feast, as they call in the priest to invoke marriage blessings, the boys wonder in silence. If God will allow this poor man take a vow to surrender his will and be doomed to compliance. For many's the bachelor gets into much for the glories of love and connubial bliss. Too late to discover his wife's not his lover, and he who wishes his missus were still just a miss. There was young Pecky Hayes, all singing the praise of the wee lass whose father was cursed with a noggin. For he knew if he married himself would be harried, his songs no lament, but his spirits were dragging. For the new Mrs. Hayes had a mouthful of knaves that she learned from her mother, a creature displeasing. Their schemes and their plots tied Pecky in knots, they'd prevent peace from pleasing his soul any season. So, young men, take care of a hoarding it air. Pick a girl that was raised to take great joy in life. The woman you had should delight in your bed, and not stand on your head like old Pecky's wife. And your old ones take warning, lest you be left mourning, that no man will wed or take your daughter's hand. If you will impart the good will of your heart, it's of peace and contentment you have full command.
Straight and perfect is the result of fear and lies. Once you realize that, you tend to start working within the forgiveness and flexibility of the medium that you work in.